water in there. And
that's neat. It's so much oil on the surface that it doesn't make a slit, a sheen anymore. It makes a layer of actual oil.
I noticed that, you know, there were planes flying, bigger planes closer in. They were spraying. And shortly after that, there's like a metallic taste. And when we got home, even before we left, we started all getting sick. Just, you know, we thought we had the flu. But I know now we were poisoned.
We napalmed from Louisiana all the way over to the west side of Florida. And we're pretending that nothing, everybody's fine.
There are millions of people who've been exposed. Certainly tens of thousands are currently experiencing some level of symptoms, which many of which will develop into serious ones. And a much larger population, on the order of hundreds of thousands of people, are highly at risk. And based on their exposure, they could develop cancer, pulmonary problems, liver failure and death, kidney failure and death, neurological problems leading to epileptic seizure type of things, a whole range of health problems which eventually cause that person to die a lot younger than they should.
It was my first time working with oil, on the oil spill. The burn and the smell was, you know, just alone was pretty terrible. It was, I mean, and without a respirator, I mean, it was kind of tough. It was kind of unbearable. But, you know, we was out there trying to make it.
The 100% of oil spill workers are sick. If they were close to that oil, they sick.
This is a safety data sheet dealing with the Corexit. And in the Corexit of the safety data sheet, and you know, in sections 311 and 312, the material safety data sheet requirements, our hazard evaluation has found this product to be hazardous. As you can tell, it's X'd, immediate acute health hazard. I asked for a respirator, and they told me that would be an active termination.
45 miles away from the Gulf. When a strong wind comes through, I can't let my children outside.
How many times my children sat down eating their food? While they're eating their food, blood pour out in their plate.
They actually said if her parents wouldn't have brought her to the hospital, within the next 12 hours, she'd have lost both of her legs.
This is a 7-year-old.
Start with one little bitty spot. Next thing you know, eating where you get in a hole, and then it starts spreading and eating more.
Their babies stay sick. All my friends' babies are staying sick.
You wake up in the morning and pull her sheets back, and the bed's full of skin. They call her Scab Girl at school.
The long-term consequences for populations, effects on reproduction, growth, development, performance, those are the kinds of effects that we're starting to see in our animals. So what that says is the red flags, the short-term effects that are predictive of long-term effects, are the ones that we're seeing now. It's the canary in the coal mine. If it's happening to the killifish, that's happening to other animals. It's happening to the canary, lookout miner.
There's crabs with shells that are actually partially dissolved.
It has no eyes. It has tumors on the sides of its head.
Skin disorders and blood disorders. And this is actually coming all the way up to dolphins now. Some of the dolphins that are washing ashore are coming in also with no eyes.
We all know what it is. It's the oil. It's the dispersant. And if we don't get help, what's gonna happen? We're all just gonna die.
It's no doctors around here that is saying what it really is.
They will not say it's all spill related, and they won't treat you for anything chemical like that.
They're saying we're not gonna admit it's dangerous, because once they admit it's dangerous, then they gotta start paying people more money.
It's all about the money.
Of course it's all about the money, come on. Of course it's all about the money. Come on. If it wasn't all about the money, I wouldn't be in business.
Stand strong. Be ready. Because if it happened to them, they're going to get the same treatment. The same as what they're doing to us. Because they don't care about your color. They don't care about nothing. All they care about is that dollar.
It's not if, it's when. It's like a hurricane. It's going to happen again. And when it happens again, it could be south of New York. It could be outside of North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, off of Santa Barbara. It could be anywhere. And that's what people need to wrap their mind around. This is not about, hey, I don't give a shit about the Gulf. So research in your own backyard.
A deer found in the water.
I don't like Ambridge.
Why don't you like Ambridge?
Because they just keep ruining other people's lives.
It's just he's a perfectly healthy child, and now he's got all these problems after the oil spill.
Like, they're able to do jumping jacks, they're able to do all these exercises in gym that I just can't do because of the oil spill.
Why are we still getting sick? And they won't give me answers. Oh, it's clean, it's safe, it's this, it's that. Live here then. Tell me it's clean and it's safe. And your company says it's not harmful. But yes, like I said, I'm not going to make it to my 50th birthday. I'm 49 years old.
Did they ever try to evacuate you?
No, they said if I go outdoors to stay out no more than 5 minutes.
And he died of a seizure in the house 3 days before she died from cancer.
All right.
Yeah, I got two in 1 week at Christmas.
And did you go to the hospital and see your doctor about it?
Yeah.
And what did your doctor say?
She said that's where it came from, the smell. It affected my asthma real bad. And then they had to put me on oxygen.
My memory is absolutely shot.
And you said your lungs are really bad?
Yep, I was just diagnosed with emphysema. They said I had the lungs of an 83-year-old man.
And you were fine before that?
And I was fine before that. And that dog was healthy as a horse until that oil spill. And the other people down here have a dog, and it's been seriously sick. I think a lot of things contribute to the oil spill.
I had to give my children's father CPR myself to save his life. He had one seizure in front of the kids at home.
We've had, I believe, 6 people that have died here. We just had another person 2 days ago die at Baker Trailer Park.
I noticed some problems with my lungs that I never had before.
Right.
You know.
And I believe that's from all the chemicals you breathe in.
Yep.
Severe headaches, nausea, fatigue, forgetfulness, all of it.
What was some of your symptoms that you had after the oil spill?
I had 3 seizures at the other house and 2 seizures where I live now.
And then my son actually had an episode where he looked like he was having seizures, passing out. I even took him to the ER.
I got migraines. I had a seizure for the first time in my life.
The oil and gas industry, the dishonesty that these people possess and the things that they do that are detrimental to communities is almost beyond belief. And they have no compassion whatsoever. They have no honesty. They have no pride. And they're worried about the bottom line. The bottom line is the bottom line.